Hello YouTube, it is Damien, it is The Return, it is episode 62 of The Return, and today we have Dortmund in the Champions League semi-final. If you have not gone and checked it out, we knocked out Real Madrid, we've knocked out Man City. I highly recommend you see the journey to how we got here. Today, we have the chance to finally make our first Champions League final as Mets manager. Since we last met, we are top of the league by 3 points, and we won a crazy game against PSG to win the French Cup 3 days ago. We're going to show you the full goals as well before we start breaking down this Dortmund side and then getting into the away leg in Germany before bringing you that home leg in a week's time. As you can see, we won 6-3 here against PSG. We were 3-1 up here, and PSG scored 82 and 88th minute to bring it to extra time in a game that we were dominating until that stage. Todd also made a pretty big defensive mistake and never recovered, but I didn't want to bring him off because he has the experience, but he had a pretty shocker, as you can see here. So we're 1-0 down, playing 4-3-3 in the diagonal system in how we started. In the end, we did alright. Unfortunately, we lost Daniel Santoro to injury again, and it looks like his season could be over with a twisted ankle. I feel for the lad because he's world class, and he hasn't been part of this Champions League campaign. As you can see, we've got a goal back there with Fabio Silva, and now Holzak gets in on the inside, and he puts it under Rulli, who I will note had a shocker, and is coming to FC Metz as the backup keeper next year on a pre-contract. Rulli himself, look, secret agent Rulli. You know, he was in fine form. You'll see in extra time why and how much fine form he was. As we see, 3-1 up there with Hadzic, and you thought it was game over, especially with how well we defend. But PSG do not die without trying. Neymar at the back stick, who's running out of contract but wants 400k a week, so we're not going to sign him, gets one. And then 88th minute, just too much space afforded here to Mr. Geyer. Comes inside, he buries, and it is 3-3. Fortunately enough for us, Rulli decides to have a shocker, and instead of running at the ball, runs around in a circle, misses it, and Fabio Silva comes in and virtually runs the ball into the back of the net, and away we go for 4-3. Nori then put a ball in, Pellegrini knocks down, Moriba hits it, in the end Rulli gets hands to it, but only pushes it into the post and in, and it makes it 5-3 before we score a very fortuitous away own goal to kill the game off. And there we go. The chat are trying to say that we could do the treble this year, and it is a very big possibility. Dortmund, who we do have in the Champions League semi-final, do sit sixth in the Bundesliga and are having a very poor year and are in a position where they could miss out on Europe altogether if they do not get something out of the Champions League. They did knock off Leipzig to get here to this stage, and as you can have a look here, they beat Leipzig 0-0 away from home, but 1-2-1 at home. They beat Lyon 0-0, 2-1 away from home as well, and they got through a Champions League Group E, which was pretty easy with Milan and Dynamo Kiev, probably one of the easiest groups around in this year's Champions League. Dortmund's run-in has not been as hard as ours, and Dortmund's run-in hasn't been tested as much, and yet they've struggled. On the other hand, we are Mets, we're top of the tree, we just won the cup, we could do a double, and by all means the treble was on. If you were a betting man and the four Mets is in, you would imagine we are hot favourites to make our first Champions League final. But this Dortmund side are no mugs. They have Julian Brandt still, who's absolutely amazing. They have Christor, who is their club captain and is definitely someone I would sign. And they do have Emre Can, who even though he's starting to decline, is still absolutely crazy as a centre mid. So the team itself is not bad. Unfortunately, with the injury to Daniel, we do have to play Moriba in the shadow striker role. Niles comes in as the deeper line, but it's Leno in goals, O'Connor, Tosin, Todd, and Nouri. Trincano's back from injury and will start today, and it will be Hadzic, Moriba, and Silva up top. North Beach is a devoted Dortmund fan and does predict Dortmund to win 4-0. Anyone else with a score prediction, though, put it in, and we are about to get underway in the first leg of two for the semi-final of the Champions League. Can we make our first final? We're about to find out. If we can have a first leg like we did against City and win a game 4-0, we would be all but there. It's a great opportunity to show the boys why we're backing up. That's a great team talk. Going to go out there and do what we always do, which is press, ladies and gentlemen. And hopefully we go out there and do the jobs. Let's not be so negative. My team picks itself as very strong, and Trincano has been in great form. Had the utmost confidence in Moriba to do his job as well, and hopefully we'll be okay. Early doors here. Hopefully we'd be okay. An away goal would be massive for us. We also know that if we can just keep things tight here in this first leg, in France, it's a different kettle of fish and we know how to score goals. So hopefully this game kind of doesn't peter out. A 0-0 wouldn't be the worst. An away goal would be massive. A game which we're not more than a goal behind would be also great too. So a 1-0 or 2-1, stuff like that. 28 minutes played. Not much has happened at the moment. We're going to tell everybody get creative. And hopefully we can find a highlight not too far into the distant future. At the moment, a very boring game here against Dortmund. And it's not like us to not create a highlight. 44 minutes played. It is 0-0 at half time. And this has been a very, very boring first leg. I don't mind, but so won't Dortmund. I'm going to tell us to demand a little bit more here. We are dominating the game in terms of what we're doing out here. I'm actually going to probably tell us to do something that's a little bit strange. A bit short on the passing at a bit of a lower tempo. Really get a bit more narrow and really keep control of that ball and really try and ping it around and get it into the box. Something that has worked this season. Trincano, though, is lacking a bit of fitness and we are going to bring in Adam Holzak here for him. In the end, there's a corner going in and it's because we're making a freaking change, Dortmund get a goal. Because we're making a change for the corner, Dortmund get a goal. Oh my guys. So because we're trying to make a tactical change, Dortmund get a highlight, and it is 1-0. And he looks miles offside there, but apparently not. Yes, proceed to changes. And now we need a goal here in Germany, you do think. Going to tell us to get creative as well. It hasn't really happened out there, though. 75 minutes, and I will take a goal if it wants to come. It's not really happening. Going to switch in the 4-2-4. Reba in. Niles in there. Rodgers not having his best of the game. Pietro Pellegrini's coming in. And hopefully, we find something here. Johnny Raz also for O'Connor. We deserve something. We really do. 1-0 at the moment. Going to tell the boys to just demand a bit more here with 10 to play. We're in the 4-2-4. Tossing on it. Inside the Niles. He can find a ball. Johnny Raz bombing on. Holzak in front of his man, but Johnny Raz plays him eventually. Numbers in the box. Cuts it. Fabio. Hadzic. Fabio. No one. Why didn't Fabio Silva shoot with his head? Why did he not just head the ball in the back of the net? In the end, it falls to Christian Adjar, and he goes long. If they score, I would be livid. We are about to get FM. Brad Leno, oh my days. We're going to get absolutely FM'd in the semi-finals. They get a highlight from fucking nothing. They get a highlight from fucking nothing. And then Fabio Silva in the six-yard box, instead of headering into the open back of the net, tries to head it down for Hadzic. They go one ball over the top and it's 2-0. It's typical FM. We need a goal and we need it now. It is not happening out there. Come on, boys. We need a highlight. We need a highlight. It's a highlight, but we need it to be for us. Holzak, pick it up. Pellegrini, we need you, Fabio Silva. It's going to be, hopefully he cuts it. Please cut it. Please cut it. Please cut it. He does. Fabio, oh, it's a save. 2-1 would have been massive. 2-0, not good enough. And we stare semi-final exit in the face. If it's 3-0, it's all but over. Leno makes the save. I'm a bit shell-shocked. They did nothing in the first half, and they were doing nothing until we made a change. We have moved to a lower tempo more times than once in the back end of this season. It's worked. And now we stare defeat in the face. We're 2-0 down, and we've got nothing but everything to play for in that second leg. We have to go for it. And it's going to take a monumentous comeback to get into the Champions League final. I'm a bit heartbroken, I'm not going to lie. They did nothing. Absolutely nothing. And we get a bit FM. The stats won't show you that. The stats will show it was even. But they didn't do anything in terms of creating a chance or a highlight. It's come from when I've gone to press pause and people will know back at FM 16-17, every time you didn't press pause, you copped the highlight. And then Fabio Silva, have a look at it. Why are you, the best striker in the world, not headering this ball on fucking target? Instead, he's trying to header it back to Hadzic, which in the French Cup final, sure. But that was from the penalty spot. 6 yards, back yourself in. Fucking put the header. Ridiculous. It's a long ball here, but it starts here. Look where Fabio is. How are you not just headering it into this space? Instead, he tries to head it to Hadzic, and in the end doesn't get there. It's good defending from Emre Can as well. But if he just decides and just goes, boom, it's 1-1, happy days. Instead, it looks like we're going out in the semi-final stage. to a Dortmund side that's sixth in the Bundesliga. Welcome back, YouTube. It's Damien, and we have it all to do here in the second leg. In the meantime, we just played Nantes, 0-0 draw. All of a sudden, instead of being 3 points ahead, we're now 1 point ahead in the league with free to play, and it's getting nervy there too. It's just crazy to think that we just beat City 4-0. We beat Strasbourg 4-0, FCSM 3-0, right? And then a 6-0 against PSG, and then apparently we can't score against Dortmund or Nantes. And when that starts happening, you go back to what you know. And what we know is a heavy press, counter-attacking system that's focused on we will outscore you. And today, that is exactly what we have to do. It's going to be Leno in goal. It is going to be Johnny Raza, Tosin, Todd and Nouri. It's got to be Mori in goal. Screw it. Get him in. I have faith he's had a good year. If he makes a mistake, my fault. I hold my hand up. Nothing against Leno. He's not like he's played bad. And he's done well enough in the cup. I just think today, if we're going to play this system, I'm going to have to need a keeper that's going to be able to move off the line. And I think Mori's that guy. Johnny Raz, Tosin, Todd and Nouri. Moriba and Niles. Holzak has it. Pellegrini and Silva. This is a team that on its day can go out there and score 4 or 5. The game plan's simple. We need to score 4. The reason why I say we need to score 4, we can afford to concede 1, which we always do in this bloody system, right? But the thing is, I think we're good enough to score 4. If this man gets going, we know. If Fabio gets going, we're good enough to outscore any team in world football, and we are good enough to overturn 2 goals. Chelsea got through their semi-final versus Zebre as well, and they await the finalist. It is a very similar side to what we just witnessed play against us in the first leg, in the 4-2-3-1. But this is a game where we need to go out there, we need to go score first, we need to go hard, and we need to go heavy. And there's no point dying without trying. We could go 4-3-3, especially if scored 4 against City. But I just think when you're 2-0 down and you know you have to do it, I'd rather just go for it. And away we go. Score predictions in the chat. Can we go out there? Is it going to be our time? Or is it going to be us going out at the last hurdle before the big dance? And it's all to do. It's all our own fault. We didn't play well enough against PSG to win it in 90. And we didn't play well enough to do anything in Germany. Nor did they, but there we are. 10 minutes in, we need an early goal as well. I'm just going to tell us to demand a bit more from the get-go. We need something early. And this is not the start we wanted, but it's a highlight. Pellegrini and the Johnny Raz. Ball into the box. It's cleared away. And this is the dangerous part about playing this system, is I don't know who this rallying bloke is, but if he's quick, he can do a job. Anyway, Mori's on it, and he's good with his feet. So Blob reckons we're going to win this one 5-2 a normal time and get through just. Well, if it's 5-2, it's 5-2. Ball into Pellegrini, knocks it in. Fabio Silva, nowhere to be seen. And in the end, it's long towards Rayleigh, but Todd's on it. Niles now. He looks for Fabio. It's picked him. It's Fabio time. Has to score. He's put it wide. We can't afford to miss chances like that. We need a goal before halftime. Corner. We're good from them. Moriba. Pellegrini doesn't win it. Headed away. Only as far as Fabio. Moriba's still out there. Whip it in. He does. Backstick. Holzak. Volleys back across the box. Only as far as Niles. Chips it back to Moriba. Constant pressure. His ball in. Holzak heads straight at the keeper. Is it going to be another one of these Champions League ties where we dominate and we don't score? Trescoffi goes long. It's cleared, but only as far as Tosin. He punts it towards Silva. Good touch in the Pellegrini. Silva's in. 1v1. Big chance. Fabio, it's another save from the Dortmund keeper. And again, it's like the Mets sides of old where you just don't score. We need one before halftime. Johnny Raz's ball in. It's in. Pellegrini. It's going to be disallowed? No, it's not. It just looked like that it was going to be disallowed. Because we didn't see the start of the highlight properly. Keeper's come and missed it. I thought it was off. It just looked like, because I saw him go to his ear. It's counted. It's 1-0. It's all good. Dortmund yet to have done anything. We need another goal. And then we're back on level terms. It's 1-0 here in the Champions League semi-final. Going to tell us to get... Well, it's a highlight. It's going to tell us to get creative here. Hadzic now. Lodi's booked. And he's going to be off. Dortmund down to 10. We have more than a half of football left to overturn a 1-goal deficit. This is huge. Johnny Raza is on the park. It's a Johnny Raza world, and he can hit a free kick. Raza steps up. Trzaskowski skates. It fills the holes like it's 2-0. Come on, boys. From 2-0 down in Germany, 37 minutes played, it's 2-2 in France. Keeper pulls up a great save, it falls to Adam Holzak, he pops it home. And now we have a whole half of football, Dortmund are down to 10, and it's all about us now just coming out there and finding the last one. A Dortmund goal would be crazy right now though. Team talk. I'm pleased with how it's going on the night. We need another one. It will come surely. Until the boys get creative out here. Dortmund have a few bookings out there themselves as well. And another one for Emre Can. Time is ticking. Fabio's not had his best of the game. But at the moment, Dortmund is freaking parking the bus and it's working. 60 minutes played. It's a highlight. 3-0 and Dortmund have to come out and try and score. If they score on the break though, we have to score two again. Rainier back in the gab. Gab now. Zagadou goes long. Surely it's ours. Well done, Todd. Hadzic knocks. Moriba. Numbers with him. Steady beats his man. He's in the box. He's gone for goal. It's just wide. It's just wide. This is good from the boys at the moment. Gonna bring in Rodri for Niles. If they score now, if they score because we're trying to make a change like they did in the first leg, I will bloody lose it. Emre Can. In the gab. Goes long. Should be Tossens. His header is to nobody. Oh my God. I've got a bad feeling. Mori. Todd. I just want this to be a pointless highlight. Really. I've had enough that they... I don't know what's been happening of lately, but FM has gone back to the days of FM 16, 17, where highlights happen when you're making changes. Johnny Raznia. Just knock it inside, John. Niles. Chips. Hazic, oh my days, how do you go so high and far over? It's 30, it's, oh come on, Johnny Raz balling back stick. Todd, headers, falls in, Moriba, it's in. Come on boys, we are 20 minutes away from a Champions League final. 20 minutes away from a Champions League final. Now it's the decision. They're down to 10. Do we stay on the system? Or do we go 4-3-3 and just be a little bit more smarter about it? I am not so sure what we do. I think I would kick myself if I didn't switch in the 4-3-3. I would kick myself. Trincano. Pellegrini's going to stay out there for the moment, but I would go to park the bus a little bit later. It's a highlight though. Hopefully it's just four and then we know it's game. If it's Dortmund scoring, then I don't know. Anyway, it's picked off by Rodri anyway. He's got numbers inside. Hadzic knocks. Fabio Silva. He's put it straight at the keeper. It was the chance to put us into the Champions League final for sure. One goal for Dortmund, mind you, add, would put them through on away goals. It is a high stressful moment. They've had one shot all game. It would be a true FMing. At the moment, though, I think going defensive and setting up shot would be a mistake. It would allow 10-man Dortmund side to start lumping numbers forward. Trincano goes for goal. It's blocked. We're not far away. Tossen to Hadzic. Hadzic now puts it back into Nouri. Nouri chips. Trincano, we're there. It's all she wrote. That fat lady singing and Dortmund are going back to Germany with nothing to show. Mess have come from 2-0 down to go 4-0 up on the night. Dortmund now need 2-7. And I tell you what, boys, it's not happening because I'm shutting up the shop. Bring on Ben. Ben in there. Moriba in there. Has it silver like that. Go to balanced. I don't even care. Just relax. Slow, lower tempo. Just waste a bit more time. Yeah. Don't need to be more expressive. Confirm that. Kill the game, please. No highlight. Get through. We are going to be there. Make it even 5 on the night. Moriba's ball in. It's going to be a penalty. It's going to be a penalty. And from 2-0 down in Germany, we are going to send Dortmund packing with a hiding. We knew we had it in us. Fabio Silva, he's hit the post. Falls to Trincano. Fabio with an assist, sure. That's how we did it. We planned it. You got the suit ready? The suit is in the cupboard. The suit is in the cupboard, lads. It is 5-0 on the night for Metz. It's 5-2 overall. And we've gone from not being able to score a goal to here we go. We are officially in a Champions League final. We are one of a handful of teams that were able to get it done. So Blob is claiming that he got 5-2 right. I'm going to go with him. Screw it. You meant it like that. Boom. We hit it again. Love it. We're into a Champions League final, boys. We are in to a Champions League final. Oh, my days. From 2-0 down to 5-2. We said before the game, we have to go for it in the 4-2-4. We're one of a handful of sides that could go out there and score 5 or 6. I said we needed 4. In the end, 5 was enough. And we are there for the Champions League final. We qualify for the Club World Cup. I don't know why we do. But Chelsea versus Metz in the final. There is history in this game. It's obviously our first ever final. But we obviously played Chelsea in the Champions League not too long ago. But we will recap that. We will recap that when we get to it. I'm delighted. It's a brilliant feeling. Had a very good game with the assist that he got. He should have scored the pen, obviously. You're not giving my team... We played him off the park. We did. I'm pleased and remain confident Kevin will be at the club. Hadzic, by the way. This is the thing that he's been doing. We've been playing him as a balanced playmaker. He doesn't get the numbers, but the things that he does on the ball and the key passes he plays and the dribbles he completes when he plays an advanced playmaker is unbelievable. Next time we see you, YouTube, hopefully we've won the league and we do our part, which could be giving us a chance to do the treble. Next time we see each other, I'll be in the suit and it will be the Champions League final versus Chelsea. Where's it being held? At the Stadio de France. Is it not scripted that a French side wins it at the Stadio de France? Who knows? But when I see you next, we'll be in France for a Champions League final.